don't fence me in. You know, many stories come in out of the era of the cowboy. Stories of bravery, villainy, even romance. But we didn't know which of those to write about. So our tale has it all. Our story is about the romantic duos, or rather disreputable lawbreaker, named Wildcat Kelly. Now Wildcat lives up to his name in all respects, has a knack for getting himself into difficult situations. And as you should see, this time he may have got himself in just a little too deep. At the beginning of our story, the cowhands have bedded down their herd on the range for the night and have had their evening chow. And as cowhands often do, they gathered around the campfire a bit before hitting the hay themselves.
Oh, Shenandoah, I love you. big open spaces, big sky, big moon, big bright stars, big cattle,
big mouths, big heads, big women. What happened to you? Smoked too much as a kid?
Well, we know about Texas, all right.
As hard as
as I walk out on the streets of Laredo.
great story, fellas. I know Laredo well. A boom town sitting out in the middle of the prairie. I truly love the prairie. When my time comes, that's where I want to be laid to rest.
Come on. What do you suppose it was?
Oh, you fellas have been smoking too much of that local weed.
Seems that he's been yapping about ghosts and death and all that. I got me a poem I cut out of the paper the other day. What does reincarnation mean? A cowboy asked his friend. His pal replied, it happens when your life has reached its end. They comb your hair and wash your neck and clean your fingernails, lay you in a padded box away from life's travails. A box and you goes in a hole that's been dug in the ground. Reincarnation starts in when you're planted neat a mound. Then clods melt down, and just like your box, and you who is inside, and then you're just beginning on your transformation ride. In a while, the grass will grow upon your rendered mound, till someday on your older grave, a lonely flower is found. And say, a horse should wander by and graze upon this flower that once was you, but now has become your vegetative flower. The posy that the horse done ate up with his other feed makes bone and fat and muscle essential to the steed. But some is left that he can't use, so it passes through. Finally lays upon the ground this thing that once was you. Then say by chance, I wanders by and sees this on the ground. I ponders and I wanders at this object that I found. I thinks it's reincarnation of life and death and such. I come away and conclude, Dan, you ain't changed so much.
While
Well, you know Sally Jane, the boss's niece. He's been trying to get her married off to us forever. But we've always managed to escape. Yeah. Until now, that is.
Now just shut up.
Leaves that wildcat. Kiss Sally Jane the other night. And now the pretty young thing's smitten with her. When the boss gets rid of it, he's gonna expect Wildcat to marry her.
I met a gal in
special.
Well, I still prefer my horse. Never ask any questions. Always does what I ask.
Well, I'd rather kiss a woman.
Well, boys, I better be on the way.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. I hear horses.
See you.
I don't say it's the second act. Oh, work out! You've got
1 week.
One week to propose to Sally Jane. If you haven't proposed to her by then, we're gonna come looking for you, and you won't have it so good.
Well, it looks like Bobcat's sure having a deep trouble this time. Sheriff's got his eye on him. Top lights aren't going to let him off the hood. And Sally Jane, that would be true of that. What's going to happen next? Well, first off, we'll